Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have some interestingness that happened in Poland recently, unexpectedly, but yeah, I'll give you some background and I'll show you some clips, and you guys can go ahead and live react with me on this whole ordeal. So basically what happened is, we've been very much talking about in the recent years, last decade or so, about women's rights and stuff like that. And I'm here for it, man. Equality. As of late, I'd say within the last 5-6 years, we've been talking about equality in the world of sports. You know, why does the WNBA not get as many views as the NBA? Why is it that, in fighting sports, you have women that don't get as much pull as men do when they go up to fight? Why is that? So Poland had the brilliant idea of making an intergender MMA sparring match, like a sparring tournament. So yes, women could fight men, and vice versa. So we can, you know, once and for all get to see in front of millions of people the effects of that. So here I actually have a clip from that fight, and it is pretty interesting. YouTube took it down? Oh, sheesh.
What's going on, you guys? Wow. Yeah, you see the title. The woman is a female arm wrestler by the name of Ula Saitovic.
So she fought this dude, this guy over here, this big ass dude.
About as the woman suffered a series of blows as the crowd shouted and cheered. Absolutely insane.
Look at this, man.
And your boy being a combat sports fan, I've seen some crazy things.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell are you guys doing over there in Poland?
Poland is out here wilding, bro. So basically, this woman got her kicked in. This guy was beating the ever-living dog out of her. If you've seen Dragon Ball Z, Nappa versus Videl, it's pretty much one of them situations where Nappa was going to town on this little, like, you know, just look at the size difference. Buddy's huge, she's like not as big, and she's getting mollywop, man. It's like boxing, right? Wrestling, MMA, there are rules in place to make sure that people aren't getting mollywopped and beat up to the point where they have to get hospitalized. Well, fortunately, she didn't have to get hospitalized as far as I know. But something that makes the fights a little bit more fair and entertaining to watch, but also ultimately keeping the fighters themselves safe. So, I don't know. I feel like in order for that to ever happen, and I feel like it would never be socially acceptable, I'm not even really completely for it, to be honest, right? I'm not totally for it, but I can see how people would be like, hey, like, you know, why can't women fight men? Why can't men fight women? It's too dangerous, bro. It is too dangerous. And I'm telling you, man, Yeah, it's all talk until you step in that ring and get your jaw realigned, you know what I mean? But why did she agree to that in the first place? I have no idea. I have no idea why she agreed to do something like this in the first place. Maybe she thought she could be the first one to change the game. Everybody wants to be a first, like be the first woman to knock out a man. And that can't happen. All it takes is 6 pounds of pressure. I mean, you can connect with the right at the right time. Boom. It has happened before. You know what I mean? But like when you have a exclusive cage match, like boom, like this, and the rules aren't really calibrated in a way where the people are totally safe, mainly the woman, it's unfortunate, very unfortunate. They should put Rose Namajunas versus that guy. She could destroy him high key. Oh, maybe. I mean, honestly, maybe. Like, it really depends. So literally, like, I feel like if they have a nice rule set, this might be a lot more acceptable in the future. It might take a while for people to wrap their head around the process of this, but I feel like it'd be a huge, you know, the deal in the future, like if we can even things out a little bit more. But yeah, man. Yeah, it's like putting a chihuahua and a pit bull in the ring. For real. The chihuahua now has to, like, outthink the pit bull, because you are not about to, like, beat up the pit bull in a match of brute strength. Like, that's just not going to happen. So anyways, that's all I wanted to talk about as far as that goes, to start off everything a little bit on the more intense side. Let me know what your thoughts and feelings are in the comments down below. YouTube is taking down a lot of these videos that are showing actual clips from the fight. And rightfully so, because if you saw the clips, bro, brutal.